Well, welcome everybody. Our hymn is number 267 in our red hymnal, Joy to the World. Janet, and for the Sunday after Christmas, we're doing something a bit different. We are not having our car church up in Summit for this Sunday because I am taking a day off to spend some time with my family after all of the craziness that has happened over Christmas and all the work that went into getting everything going. And so instead of having a regular service online, we are doing something we're calling the service of readings and carols. Often we do that on our Sunday after Christmas in churches as well, but we'll be doing it for you today online. And so I'll be reading from the Gospel of Luke, and then in between we'll have songs. The songs were pre-recorded by our musicians so that we could have some special ones for the holiday seasons. Our hymn is number 283, O Come All Ye Faithful, 283.
Thank you.
And so the scripture that I'm reading for you comes from something called The Message. Well, it looks up back and forth to you guys, but it's called The Message, and it is a contemporary English Bible. So some of those old things that you know so well sound a little different when they come to you in contemporary English. And so we want to, it's a new way, a way to look at the same story. It doesn't change what the story is, but sometimes it changes the way that we look at it and the way that we hear it. If you need anything else from Pastor this week, you are welcome to give me a call or do any of those things. I will be here. It's not that I'm going anywhere away. It's just that for today, we're taking a little bit more of a break, so I'm not preaching a sermon, and we're not doing those things with Car Church. Well, we begin then with the book of Luke, the first chapter. Most people don't know that the birth of Jesus Christ and his story does not begin with his conception, but with the conception of another one named John. And so we begin with his story in the first chapter. During the rule of Herod, the king of Judea, there was a priest assigned the service of the regiment. His name was Zechariah. His wife was descended from the daughters of Aaron. Her name was Elizabeth, and together they lived honorably before God, careful in keeping with the ways of the commandments and enjoying a clear conscience before God. But they were childless because Elizabeth could not conceive, and now they were quite old. So it happened that Zechariah was carrying out his priestly duties before God, working the shift assigned to his regiment. And it came his one turn in life to enter the sanctuary of God and burn incense. The congregation was gathered and praying outside the temple at the hour of the incense burning. Unannounced, an angel of God appeared just to the right of the altar of incense. Zechariah was paralyzed in fear when he heard the voice of God. But the angel reassured him, "Don't fear, Zechariah. Your prayer has been heard. Elizabeth, your wife, will bear a son, and you are to name him John. You're going to leap like a gazelle for joy, and not only you, but many will delight at his birth. He'll receive great stature with God. He'll drink neither wine nor beer, and he'll be filled with the Holy Spirit from the moment he leaves his mother's womb. He will turn many sons and daughters of Israel back to God. He will herald God's arrival, and in the style and strength of Elijah, soften the hearts of parents to children, and kindle devout understanding among hardened skeptics. He'll get the people ready to be with our God." Zechariah said to the angel, "Do you expect me to believe this? I am an old man, and my wife is an old woman." But the angel said to him, "I am Gabriel, the sentinel of God, sent especially to you to bring you this good news. But because you won't believe me, you'll be unable to say a word until the day of your son's birth. Every word spoken to you will come true in time, God's time." Meanwhile, the congregation was waiting for Zechariah and was getting quite restless outside, wondering what was keeping him so long in the sanctuary. When he came out and he couldn't speak, they knew that he had seen a vision and were in awe. He continued speechless and had to use sign language with the people. When the course of his priestly duties were completed, he went back home, and he wasn't long before his wife Elizabeth conceived, and off she went by herself for 5 months, relishing her pregnancy. "So this," she said, "is how God acts to remedy my unfortunate condition." In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel again to the Galilean village of Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to be married to a man descended from David. He came and his name was Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary, and the angel came to her. And now we'll have a time of singing one of our favorite carols. Our hymn is number 296, What Child Is This? 296 in your red hymnals. Second reading from the first chapter of Luke, the story of the birth of Jesus. The angel Gabriel came to Mary, and upon entering, Gabriel greeted her. Good morning! You, Mary, are beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you. And she was thoroughly shaken, wondering what was behind a greeting like that. But the angel assured her, Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son and call his name Jesus. He will be called Great, the Son of the Highest. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will rule Jacob's house forever, and his kingdom will have no end. Mary said to the angel, but how will this happen? I have never slept with a man. And the angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will hover over you. And therefore the child you bring to birth will be called the Holy Son of God. And did you know that your cousin Elizabeth conceived a son, old as she is? Everyone called her barren. And here she is, 6 months pregnant. Nothing you see is impossible to God. And Mary said, yes, I see it all now. I am the Lord's maid, ready to serve. Let it be with me, just as you say. And then the angel left her. Our hymn is 290, Go Tell It on the Mountain, 290 in your red hymnals. She got up and traveled to a town in Judea in the hill country, straight to Zechariah's house. And greeting Elizabeth, when Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby in her womb leaped. And she was filled with the Holy Spirit and sang out expectantly, "You are so blessed among women, Mary, and the babe in your womb also blessed. Why am I so blessed that the mother of my Lord visits me? The sound of your greeting entered my ears, and the babe in my womb skipped like a lamb of sheer joy. Blessed woman who believes that God said, believes every word would come true." And Mary said, "I'm bursting with God's news. I'm dancing the song of my Savior God. God took one good look at me, and look what happened. I'm the most fortunate woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. And God, whose very name is holy, set upon, apart from all others. His mercy flows in wave after wave on those who are in awe before him. He bared his arms and showed his strength and scattered the bluffing braggarts. He knocked tyrants from their horses and pulled victims out of the mud. The starving poor sat down to a banquet. The callous rich were left out in the cold. He embraces his children, chosen Israel. He remembered and piled on mercies and piled them high. It is exactly as he promised, beginning with Abraham and right up until now." And so Mary stayed with Elizabeth for 3 months before she went back to her home. Our hymn number is 277, Away in a Manger, from your red hymnals, 277.
Away in a manger, no crib for his head.
About that time, Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to his own ancestral hometown to be accounted for. So Joseph went up from Galilee to a town in Nazareth, up to Bethlehem in Judea. David's town, it was called. And he went for the census, as he was a descendant of David. He had to go there. He had no choice. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. And while they were there, the time for her to give birth came. And she gave birth to a firstborn. And she wrapped him in a blanket of wool and of wrappings. And she laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds keeping watch in their neighborhood over their flock by night, and they had sat all night watching over their sheep. And suddenly God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce great news and a joyful event that was meant for everyone, for the whole world. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is the Messiah and the Master. This is what you'll be looking for when you go to look for him. You will find a baby wrapped in a blanket and in rough cloth and lying in a manger." At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir, singing praises and filling the whole night sky. And they sang, "Glory to God in the heavenly heights, and peace to men and women on earth who please him." And as the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the shepherds talked it over. "Let's go over to Bethlehem," they said, "as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us." So they left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. And seeing became believing. Our hymn is Silent Night, number 281 in your red hymnals. Silent Night 281.
Oh,
Told everyone. They told everyone they met that the angel had said about this child, and all who heard the shepherds were impressed and wondered about what could have happened. But Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within her heart. The shepherds returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God and whooping for everything they had seen and heard, and were so excited. It turned out exactly the way the angels had told them it would be. God had been born. Our hymn is number 270. Hark the Herald Angels Sing, number 270 in your red hymnals. You've enjoyed this reading of the story of Christ from our contemporary Bible. I always think what an amazing night it must have been, what amazing things must have happened to come up to them. And we know that this one event changed the world. God came to earth to be one of us, and it made all the difference. Please join me in our Lord's Prayer. Before we go, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, we hope to see you next week. Our car church will resume again at Hope Lutheran until further notice. That's where we will be doing our worships. And we will, of course, have online worships as well. If you have any special prayer concerns, you can either message us here or you can let us know by any other means, including a phone call for me if you're for someone who is local. And we'll make sure that we keep you all in our prayers. And as I tell you every week before you go, have a blessed, blessed week. Be safe, be smart, be kind, and go in peace and serve our Lord. Thanks be to God. Christ was born. We will see you next week. We love you all. Be safe.